The topic is using fundamental identities to find the exact values of the remaining trig functions. So let's do this example. Use the fundamental identities to find the exact values of the remaining trig functions of x, given that tangent is equal to square root of 17 over 2 and cosine of x is less than 0. So let's look at the definitions. We have cosine squared plus sine squared 1, 1 plus tangent squared equals secant squared, cotangent squared plus 1 is equal to cosecant squared. So let's see which one we need to use. So first we always start by writing the trig functions we're looking for. So we have cosine x, sine x, tangent x, and then secant x, cosecant x, and cotangent x. What's given? The only thing that's given is the tangent, which is square root of 17 over 2. Right? So since it's given a tangent, the only one that involves tangent would be number 2. But number 2 tells us what? We can find secant square. In other words, secant. So let's use that one. So 1 plus tangent square is equal secant square, which means secant, let me write secant on the left side. Remember, using square root method, it's a minus or plus. 1 plus tangent square of x. Now, I want to know if a secant is positive or negative. Now, remember, if a secant, if cosine is negative, cosine, secant is just 1 over cosine. So, if cosine is negative, of course, secant will be negative. Right? So, since cosine is negative, secant is negative. Right, because it's 1 over cosine, they have both same sign. So that would be equal minus square root 1 plus tangent square, because we know it's negative. Let's write here, secant is negative because cosine is negative. They both of them have the same sign, secant and cosine, always. Alright, now all we need to do is plug in the tangent. Now this is minus 1 plus tangent, we said square root of 17 over 2 right here, so square that. So secant of x is equal minus square root of 17 squared is 17, 2 squared is 4, 4 plus 17 is 21 over 4. And this is minus square root of 21 over square root of 4 is just 2. So go back here and write secant is minus square root of 21 over 2. So once we get secant, we know the cosine is just inverted. So minus 2 over square root of 21. We know the cotangent is just tangent inverse. So it's 2 over square root of 17. So the only thing we need to find is a sine. But remember, tangent is sine over cosine. Right? Which means sine is, we're looking for sine, which means sine of x is equal to tangent times cosine. Right? Just multiply both by cosine. Which means sine is tangent, we said, square root of 17 over 2 times cosine is negative 2 over square root of 21. Simplify the 2 with the 2. Don't forget the minus. This is going to be minus square root of 17 over square root of 21. So go back here and write minus square root of 17 over 21, and the cosecants, we just invert the sign, so it means square root of 21. So it will be minus square root of 21 over square root of 17, and that's it for this problem.